Hello, let's see how to enforce state limiting for the managed APIs in Kubernetes using the API operator. Please make sure to follow the previous tutorials and deploy API operator along with the API portal beforehand. When you have deployed your microservices as managed APIs in Kubernetes, you may want to limit the number of API requests based on usage and different policies. Using the API operator, you can achieve it in three simple steps. First, you have to deploy the rate limiting custom resource definition with your policy in the cluster. Then you can refer it in the Swagger definition. And using that Swagger definition, you can deploy your managed APIs in the Kubernetes cluster. There are three rate limiting types. If you want to limit the number of API requests from all the users for a particular API or a resource, you can use the advanced rate limiting type. If you want to limit the number of API requests from a particular user for a set of APIs, you can use the application rate limiting type. If you want to limit the number of API requests from a particular user for a particular API, you can use the subscription rate limiting type. For the demonstration, I have defined three policies. From the advanced type, I have allowed 3 requests per minute, and from the application type, I have allowed 4 requests per minute, and from the subscription type, only 1 request per minute. Let's deploy these 3 policies in the Kubernetes cluster. We have completed the first step. If you are using application rate limiting or subscription rate limiting, you can skip the second step and you don't have to refer the policy in the Swagger definition. But if you are using advanced rate limiting, you have to refer the name of the policy name in the Swagger definition with the XWSO2 throttling DA. If you want to limit the number of API requests for the whole API, you can refer it in the API level. And if you want to limit the number of API requests only for a particular resource, you can refer it in the resource level also. Now let's deploy our managed API using the Swagger file. It will take some time for the service to be available. Let's invoke the API and test if the rate limiting policy has been applied. I have used the default JWT token available in our GitHub repository, which can be used by all the users. Since I have applied the advanced rate limiting policy to allow only 3 requests per minute for the particular API, you can see that the 4th request has been throttled up. To demonstrate the application and subscription type of rate limiting policies, you have to generate an access token from the API portal with the specific policies. To demonstrate that, I have already created an API with the same Swagger file I used to create the API using the API operator in the Kubernetes cluster. And to test the subscription rate limiting policies, I have created an application with the unlimited application tier. And I have subscribed to the API with the subscription tier to allow only 1 request per minute. Now, let's generate the access token and invoke the API. Since I have set the subscription policy to allow only 1 request per minute, you can see the second request has been throttled out. To test the application rate limiting type, I have created an application with the application policy to allow only 4 requests per minute. And I have subscribed to the API with an unlimited subscription tier. You can generate the access token like we did earlier. And let's invoke the API with that token. Since I had allowed to have only 4 requests per minute for the application, you can see that the 5th request has been throttled out. In this tutorial, we saw how to apply rate limiting for your managed API in the Kubernetes cluster. In the description, you can find the links to the other tutorials regarding the API operator. Thank you.